bet with 20 bucks.
It's 20 bucks.
No, I don't care about the money. Okay. I just ain't about that.
I like to be right too, but it's fun when we place a little wager on it.
Black man with no money on camera, he ain't sure ain't gonna do that.
What do you guys think about the greatest loss of the century, Ronda Rousey?
Greatest loss of the century.
Well, it was definitely a huge loss, that's for sure. You know, it's one of those losses that you know, when champions lose, they go down putting up a good fight and defeat, you know. This was one of those defeats. I mean, Ronda tried to do what she could, but it was a domination the way she, I mean, you can honestly say she got her ass beat from the beginning of the first round to the end of the first round to the end of the fight. I mean, she tried to do what she could, but that was a bad loss. I hope she bounces back from it, and I wish her the best, definitely, you know. But Holly Holm,
did you expect it before the fight?
I was not expecting it, no. I mean, I knew Holly was a good boxer. I was familiar with her boxing background. But as far as her MMA skills, I wasn't really too familiar with them. So, of course, I'm going to obviously think that Ronda is going to win the fight. Just based on what I've seen in her fights. I've seen more of her fights than I have seen on Holly Holm. So, I'm automatically going to assume that. But, to our surprise, we saw what we saw. And Holly beat her soundly. And very, very, very efficiently, too. In my opinion, in terms of mixed martial arts, that was definitely a masterful performance by a female fighter. Definitely, it was.
After the fight, after the loss, Ronda Rousey didn't give any interviews to anybody. She barely just posted a picture on her Instagram saying, "Thank you, my fans, everybody." But let's face it, all her fans turned back on her, posting bad memes. Talking shit about her. What do you think about that?
Well, I'm not surprised. I was talking about it a couple days ago, and I'm not surprised just based on the amount that she has thrown out there as far as things that she has said as well. So I'm not surprised by it. But back to Holly Holm, I saw in a video recently that she actually released a statement saying, "Let's stop bashing Ronda Rousey. This isn't right. She honestly does not deserve this." And this is coming from the person that beat her. You can't be more sportsmanlike than that, you know? It's just like, hey, this is a sport. Let's have some respect for each other, you know? If you move on, because that's life, you know? Paul Williams said it best once, you know? You get in the ring, whether you spar, whether you fight. If you win, you win. If you lose, hey, you lose in there. You get out of the ring, you leave it in there, and you move on with your life. And you go and have fun and enjoy yourself, of course, definitely. Which is what I hope Ronda does. And then I hope she definitely gets back into training and improves on the things that she needs to improve on. And we'll see how she does in that rematch that's supposed to happen.
What do you think she needs to do to turn all her fans back to her?
You know what? I'm not going to say she's not humble, because she has done very, very nice things for people of the public she has. But
what does she do?
She's given back to people in need. She has helped. She's been a role model for women of domestic violence, from what I understand, you know, because she's a stand-up kind of girl. But there are a lot of things around the sports world where the whole Floyd Mayweather bashing. She never needed to go that route, really, because Floyd Mayweather is a boxer, a retired boxer now, and she's an MMA fighter. I've just always have felt if you're going to degrade or if you're going to put down somebody of a particular athlete, stay in your lane with the sport that you're in. If she's going to bash someone in the MMA world, you know, don't bash someone in the boxing world and then say that you can do this and this and that. You know, if you're doing that to market yourself and media hypeness, then I can understand that. But as an athlete and being in the sport that you're in, I do believe you want to try to stay in the lane that you should stay in with your sport, you know. So I think there's that right there. But the backlash and everything, those kind of things happen when someone's undefeated and they're kicking butt, and then we see what happens. You know, it's like, I can guarantee you this: if this something like this were to happen to Floyd, oh my gosh, it would have been nonstop. But that never did happen. It won't ever happen.
Yeah, but did you hear what actually Mayweather said?
He gave actually a complimentary response and offering a hand and help and saying, you know, hey, keep your head up, you know, hope it bounced back, of course.
Do you think Rousey would do the same?
Very, very, very hard to say. I don't get that impression. I really don't. I really don't. So hopefully these kind of acts that are being given to her from these people that she has said these things about, you know, hopefully it should open her eyes and her mind and make her realize, hey, I shouldn't hold any grudges or hate. I should move on, do my business, and enjoy life.
All right. Tell everybody how to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, anywhere.
I have an Instagram. It's outlaws_Dempsey_Mesa. And I have a Twitter. It's at Ryan J. Mesa. And I do have Facebook. It's Ryan Mesa.
All right, Ryan, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Sorry for interrupting you.
That's okay. It's all right.
I already got cold myself.
Okay. No worries.
That was a great interview. Thank you.